Okay, let's try to revise the things that you covered in digital communications course. In general, what are the noise that you encountered in digital communications? What is the noise? What is the probability density function for the noise? Yeah, one of you can answer. Is it uniform distribution? Is it Gaussian distribution? Or what is that? See, I gone through that map rule and ML rule, right? For decoding, imagine likelihood detection rule and imagine a posteriori probability detection rule. In general, what kind of noise you can expect? Okay, otherwise, we'll try to start this. Are you heard about this noise? AWGN. Yeah, what is this AWGN means?
Additive white Gaussian noise.
White Gaussian noise.
Okay, additive white Gaussian noise, right? For example, consider binary data transmission. You are transmitting either bit 0 or bit 1. For bit 0, you are transmitting, let's assume, like minus 1. For bit 1, you are transmitting 1 volt. Like this, you are transmitting. And if this got affected by additive white Gaussian noise with a distribution, is a noise distribution, normal distribution, with 0 mean and variance 2, for example. Can someone tell me what is the distribution of this, that PDF? What is the concerned probability density function? Gaussian 0 mean and variance 2. The 0 mean and variance 2. Yeah, what is that? I'll ask you a question. X is a Gaussian with mean value mu and variance sigma squared. Then what is PDF fx of x? What is that PDF? See, you might saw this, right? At least this kind of shape. The x versus fx of x. This is 0 mean, right? Yes, what is this mathematical formula for this? Okay, it corresponds to 1 by root 2 pi sigma square e power minus, x bar means mean, whole square by 2 sigma square. Is a probability density function for this Gaussian. Noise is a random variable, right? Either noise is a Gaussian random variable with mean value 0 and variance 2. Sigma square equals to 2 and mu equal to 0. In this particular example, then can you just tell me what you are receiving at the receiver? For example, bit 0 transmitted at the transmitter, you will try to receive minus 1 plus noise at the receiver. Where this noise follows Gaussian, 0 mean and variance 2 in this example. Suppose if you transmit bit 1 at the transmitter, you are trying to receive 1 plus noise at the receiver. Once again, noise means Gaussian, 0 mean and variance 2. Then what is the distribution for Y? Can you just tell me what is the PDF for Y? Is it Gaussian or not? Y? You are transmitting minus 1 and some random noise got added in the channel, and effectively you are receiving this at your receiver. Minus 1 plus noise, where noise is a random variable. It implies that Y also random variable, right? This is random variable. The sum of these two things also random variable. Can you just tell me, is it Gaussian or not? Why? See, this is also Gaussian. Here solution. If this is Gaussian, can you just tell me what is the mean value for Y? What is the mean value for Y? You know the mean value for noise, which is 0. Then what is the mean value for Y? Okay, before this, let's revise your probability once. Suppose X is a random variable with mean mu and variance sigma square. Then what about Y equals to AX plus B? What is the mean and variance for Y? What is mu Y? Where A and B are constants, then what is mu Y? Mean of Y. Y is a random variable.
A mu plus B.
Okay, this is A mu plus B, right? That's fine. Then what about variance for this Y? Sigma Y square.
A square sigma square.
Okay, this is A square sigma square, right? It's a variance, it's a mean. By the same trick, you can just tell me this, right? I give some half of the answer. If this noise is Gaussian, if you add minus 1 to this Gaussian noise, you are going to get Y to be Gaussian once again. This is also Gaussian random variable. Can you just tell me what is the mean value for Y in this case?
Minus 1.
Minus 1, right? Mean. What is the variance? Yeah, what is the variance?
2, sir.
2 only, right? You can simply apply this rule. In this case, capital X corresponds to noise. Like that, you can feel. And A equal to 1 and B equal to minus 1. Now we are going to get Y to be Gaussian with mean minus 1 and variance 2. Can you comment on this? Then what should be the distribution for this particular Y? This is also Gaussian with mean value. What is the mean? See, if you transmit bit 1, what you are receiving at the receiver is 1 plus noise. Then what is the mean value for this?
1, sir.
Mean value for this is 1, right? What is the variance of this?
2.
That is 2, right? We are going to get Gaussian mean value 1 and variance 2. Gaussian mean value minus 1, variance 2. When you transmit bit 0, when you transmit bit 1, you are receiving this one. Now let's try to plot this at the receiver. is a conditional PDF. If you transmit bit 0 at the transmitter, this is what you are receiving at the receiver. This is a concerned probability density function. When you transmit bit 1 at the transmitter, the concerned probability distribution you are going to get at your receiver, Fy, after transmitting bit 1. As you saw, this is Gaussian mean value minus 1 and variance 2. This is Gaussian mean value 1 and variance 2. Let's try to plot these two things. This corresponds to this, and this PDF corresponds to this one. See, 1 by root 2 by sigma square e power minus y bar whole square by 2 sigma square, where sigma square equals 2 and y bar equals minus 1 in this case. In this case, sigma square equals 2 and that mean y bar equals to 1. You can substitute that into this formula. Can you just tell me what is this center point? This is y.
Minus 1.
This is minus 1, right? Then what is this?
Plus 1.
This should be plus 1, right? This is plus 1. Can you guess what is this?
Mean.
This intersection. Can you just tell me this intersection value? See, both of them are having same variance, right? Variance 2 for both of them. It means that these two are perfectly identical, except some shift, right? This is with the center point of minus 1, this is with the center point of 1. These two PDFs are identical, except that change of mean. This is minus 1, this is plus 1. Shape of these two graphs are perfectly symmetric, and that too they are symmetric, right? Then at what point they can test it? When they are symmetric.
0 itself.
0, right? This is exactly at the center point. They will intersect exactly at the center point of them, right? The 0. Okay, that's fine. Now, one of you can answer. You studied ML rule, right? ML decoding rule. What is ML decoding rule?
This one only, sir.
ML decoding rule means? Okay, I will ask a question. Suppose if you receive, if you got y equal to 2.1 at the receiver, then how to decode this one? X means transmitted signal, like that again thing. Transmitted bit. Then how to decode this? Due to noise, see, what you are going to transmit is either minus 1 or plus 1. If bit 0, you are transmitting minus 1. If bit 1, you are transmitting plus 1 at the transmitter side. But due to noise, you are receiving Y, corrupted version of that signal. You can receive any Y value in this real axis which follows these Gaussian distributions. If you apply ML rule, maximum likelihood rule, these are called like likelihood functions. This is likelihood function, this is some other likelihood function when you transmit bit 1. These are called like likelihood functions. Maximum likelihood rule means you will try to assign the concerned bit which gives the maximum likelihood function out of these two. Can you just tell me what is the concerned x value? Is it bit 0 or bit 1? Y equal to 2.1. Let's
here.
Is it bit 1? Why this is bit 1? Can you just explain? bit one, that's good thing. It's fine. They say bit one. There's no doubt. You can decode it like bit one. Why? Yeah, how you decoded it like
bit one? Is greater than zero. Actually, received signal is greater than zero.
Okay. Oh, you forget about threshold. Just try to think directly in terms of your definition. Maximum likelihood rule. This is likelihood function for bit minus one. This is likelihood function for bit one. Bit zero likelihood function. This is bit one likelihood function. What is the meaning of maximum likelihood rule? Whichever the likelihood function is maximum for that particular received y value, you'll try to assign that one, right? That's a maximum likelihood rule. In this case, which one is maximum? Which likelihood function is maximum at y? If you extend this, it's a Gaussian distribution, right? This will go till infinity and minus infinity, both sides. You can see at this point, y equal to 2.1. This is bigger compared to this one, right? This likelihood function is bigger compared to this likelihood function. And you know that this likelihood function corresponds to bit one. It's a bit one, right? This likelihood function corresponds to bit zero. It's a bit zero likelihood function. This is bigger than this one. So that you can decode this like bit one. For example, if you received this one at your receiver, y equal to minus 0.4, then how to decode this? Will you decode this like a bit 0 or bit 1? Y equal to minus 0.4.
Bit zero,
right? Because at this point, you can try to compare the likelihood functions. At y equal to minus 0.4, is the likelihood function value for bit one? Is the likelihood function value for bit zero? This is bigger. Bit zero likelihood function is bigger compared to bit one, right? It means that you can try to decode this like bit zero. That's what you are doing, right? This corresponds to your ML rule. Maximum likelihood reduction rule. Okay, that's fine. Let's go to map rule. These are called like prior probabilities. Suppose you know what are the prior probabilities. Can someone explain what a prior probability means? I think just 1 month back itself we studied, right? A posteriori probability, such things in ADC course. Yeah, can you just tell me? What is prior probability? See, prior probability means this is before transmission.
Probability of transmitting, sir.
Yeah, probability of transmitting bit zero, and this is probability of transmitting bit one. In this case, I just considered probability of transmitting bit zero as zero, probability of transmission of bit one as one. Now, do you think ML rule will work out here, or do you need to go for some other rule?
No, sir.
Why it won't work?
They should be equally probable.
If they are equally probable, that will work out, right? Suppose, yes, I want to apply ML rule here. What is the problem I am going to get? Suppose I am assigning bit 0 probability 0 and bit 1 probability equals to 1. These are the prior probabilities. Suppose. Here the prior probabilities. Now what is the problem I am going to get? Suppose I received y equal to minus 0.4 is the receiver. How to decode if I apply ML rule? Yeah, how to decode? If you apply ML rule, you are going to get bit 0, right? Is it true? ML rule means maximum likelihood function. Bit 0 likelihood function is bigger compared to this one. Yield decode is like bit 0. But do you think you are going to transmit bit 0 at some time? Zero probability, right? You can try to see this one clearly. You will never transmit bit 0. You know already this thing, right? You will always try to transmit bit 1 in this particular scenario. That means whatever decoding you are doing, that's wrong. It's not a correct one. If you blindly apply ML rule here, you will try to decode this like bit 0. But from the prior probabilities, you know that you will never transmit bit 0. You will always transmit bit 1. It means you should decode this like bit 1 only, right? That's the problem here. Now what can you do? If you want to avoid such problems, what can you do? Will you go for ML rule or will you modify this rule? Which one will you prefer? Yeah, will you go for you heard about this, right? Maximum a posteriori probability rule. Which one will you apply? ML or MAP in this particular case? When prior probabilities are not equal, the two are not equal. I think
MAP
rule, right? When prior probabilities are equal, then you can simply go for ML rule. When they are equal, this one is identical to MAP rule. Both are same. When the prior probabilities are equal, these two rules are identical. There is no difference at all. When these two prior probabilities are not equal, then you should go for MAP rule. These two are not same when they are unequal. By default, you need to remember one thing. Optimal decision rule is MAP rule. Which will try to reduce the probability of error. Probability of error is small for MAP rule. By default, this is optimal rule, optimal decision rule. If prior probabilities are equal, if P0 equals to P1, MAP rule implies ML rule. The two rules are same when prior probabilities are equal. If P0 is not equals to P1, when the prior probabilities are unequal, then MAP rule is the optimal. You can just have one of them. Anyone is fine in this case because both are equal, right? When prior parties are equal. When they are unequal, by default, you should go for MAP rule. Imagine a posteriori probability rule. Yeah, one of you can explain what is MAP rule.
Go with posteriori probabilities.
Okay, go with a posteriori probabilities, right? A posteriori probability means bit 0 after receiving y. Probability of bit 0 after receiving y. And probability of bit 1 after receiving y. These are called as a posteriori probabilities. And these are called like likelihood functions. F of y after 0. They are the PDFs, right? Y after transmitting bit 1. These are called as likelihood functions. And P0, P1. These are called as prior probabilities. Imagine likelihood rule means you will try to see whichever is giving maximum out of the two. That you will try to assign. Imagine likelihood. Imagine a posteriori probability rule means you will try to assign bit 0 if this is bigger than this one. You will try to assign bit 1. You will try to decode it like bit 1 if this is bigger than this one. A posteriori probabilities, right? Yeah. Can you simplify this further? Is there any way to express this one as a function of the two? You can apply Bayes' rule, right? If you apply Bayes' rule, yeah, what will happen if you apply Bayes' rule? Probability of bit 0 after y equals to, what is that? Is it okay? P0 into f of y after transmitting bit 0 divided by, what is this? F of y, right? And this one corresponds to, if you apply Bayes rule for this one, P of 1 into f of y after transmitting bit 1 divided by f of y. See, if you have doubt, you can go with this one. This one is same as f of y comma 0, and this one is same as f of y comma 1. Let's go with the notations that you are familiar with. Can you just tell me this expansion? Can you write like this? A intersection B by P of B. Is it true? It's fine, right? And which can be written like this? P of A into P of B after A. This can be written like this. It's a Bayes rule, right? And the Bayes theorem can get this. Yes, maximum a posteriori probability rule means you'll try to see whether this is maximum value or this is maximum value. You'll try to compare. For the received y value, you'll try to see whether this function is maximum or this function is maximum. If this is maximum compared to this one, then you'll decode like bit 0. If this is maximum compared to this one, then you'll try to decode this like bit 1. It's a map rule, right? Maximum a posteriori probability rule. Okay, do you need to bother about denominator in this case? Is it required? Let's try to rewrite this once again. It's a map rule, right? Imagine a posteriori probability decoding rules. Yeah, then how to decode this? If this is true, how can you decode
bit zero.
If this is true? Bit 0, right? If this is true, if this is less than this one, then how to decode?
Bit 1.
This is bit 1, right? You'll like decode this like bit 1. Whichever you imagine that you want to assign, that's what you are doing. Can you cancel this one? Is it okay? Is there any problem if I cancel these two terms? These two are identical, right? Function of y, function of y. F of y, f of y, that's it.
Yes, sir.
You just You can cancel them, right? That means if this is bigger than this one, then you can decode it like bit 0. If this is smaller than this one, then you can decode this like bit 1. Like that you can do, right? This is a map rule. Imagine a posteriori probability rule. ML rule means that won't contain this prior probability. This weightage won't be there, right? Prior probability weightage won't be there for ML rule. For example, if these two are equal, if P0 equals to P1 equals to 1 by 2, then you can cancel the two things, right? Then that will be same as your ML rule. When they are equal, when they are unequal, you can't blindly cancel them, right? Okay, let's try to go back to our example. These are the likelihood functions, and this is 0, this is minus 1, this is plus 1, this is y. ML rule means what we are doing is whichever you imagine that we are selecting. For example, if I go with this P0 equals to 1 by 4, then what is P1? P0 is 1 by 4, what is P1?
1 by 4 3 by 4 3 by 4,
right? It's 3 by 4 because total value should be 1. Now I'll try to go for map rule. Map rule means I'll try to multiply with prior probabilities, some weightage with prior probabilities I am giving, and P1 into Fy after 1 of y. Here P0 means 1 by 4 and P1 means 3 by 4, right? This is 0.75. Now what happens to this one? Will it go up or down? This curve. Multiply with 0.25. Will it go up or down?
Down.
Down, right? Let's have something like this. Yes. What happens to this one if you multiply with 0.75? Will it go up or down? It is less than 1 only, right? What will happen? Go up or down?
Down only, sir.
Down only, right? But compared to this, this is somewhat high, right? This is,
yes,
3
sir.
Times compared to this one. You might find somewhere here. See, this is just for intuition and drawing. This may not be exact one. Yeah, that's fine. You'll get something like this. If you apply ML rule straight away, what is the threshold you are keeping indirectly? How to decode if y less than 0? You can see, right?
Zero.
Zero, right? Because for y less than 0, this is always bigger compared to this one. This curve is bigger than this curve, right? For y less than 0. You can decode like bit 0. And y greater than 0, 1, right? When coming to map rule, in this particular example, what will be the threshold? Is it 0 or something different? Is it 0? These two are a posteriori probabilities. You can see this is a posteriori probability for bit 0 and this one is a posteriori probability for bit 1. You will try to see whichever is maximum out of them, that will consider. For example, up to this point, which one is maximum up to this? Is it bit 0 or bit 1?
Bit 0.
Bit 0, right? That means up to this you can decode like bit 0. And after this, bit 1, a posteriori probability is bigger compared to bit 0, right? You will decode it like bit 1. Now, what is this threshold? You are reading this threshold, something less than 0, right? We don't know. We need to calculate that one. That's not required at present. This threshold is somewhere less than 0, right? This map rule. That's the thing you are going to get. Can someone tell me how to calculate probability of error in this particular example? Probability of error equals to how to calculate? When can you say there will be error? If 0 converted to 1 or 1 converted to 0, then you can say there is an error, right? Actually, you are transmitting bit 0, but you are decoding like bit 1. This is error. Actually, you are transmitting bit 1, but you are decoding it like bit 0. That's error, right? Can you just tell me error probability for this case? Okay, at least have a look into this figure once. Let's go for ML rule. P0 and P1 are the prior probabilities for bit 0, bit 1. Let's go for ML rule only. In that scenario, this is the threshold you are applying. Okay, then what is this error? 0 to 1 error. Okay, I'll try to draw that. You need to answer. Which one corresponds to 0 to 1 error? Red color or this yellow color?
Yellow color.
Yellow color, right? Because this corresponds to bit 0, this corresponds to bit 1. Density, right? 0, fy after 1. Yellow color corresponds to 0 to 1 transition. Actually, that is 0. It is actually 0. But due to noise, that y value is becoming more than 0. Because you are going to get like this, right? Y equal to minus 1 plus noise. Due to this noise, this might exceed 0. That case you want to see. And you want to see the constant area under this curve, right? When you transmit bit 0. This particular part corresponds to probability of error after transmitting bit 0. Then what about this? You can use similar thing, right? For this, what is this red color one? Probability of error after transmitting bit 1, right? After transmitting bit 1. Then what is average probability of error? See, I am really explaining in English only, right? This is probability of error after transmitting bit 0. After transmitting bit 0. This is a probability of error after transmitting bit 1. Then how to find average probability of error? First you are transmitting bit 0 with probability P0. prior probability. And after transmitting bit 0, you want to see how much error you are getting. And once again, plus first you are transmitting bit 1. And after transmitting bit 1, you want to see how much probability of error you are getting. This is the average probability of error. P naught, prior probability, probability that you are transmitting bit 0, into after transmitting bit 0, you want to see how much error you are expecting. Same thing for this one. See, this thing you should do it easily, right? Just for your understanding, consider x is a random variable which can take the values x1, x2 up to xn, discrete random variable, with constant probabilities p1, p2 and so on, pn. Then what is the value for e of x? Mean value or average value. How to find this? These are the values, these are the constant probabilities. X is a random variable, discrete random variable. Then what is mean value e of x or average value? What is that?
X1 into P1 plus.
Okay, P1 and X1 plus P2 H2 plus and so on plus PN XN, right? You are doing the same thing here. This is like probability for bit 0, and after transmitting bit 0, you want to see how much error is there into PE after 0. Plus, you are transmitting bit 1, after that you want to see how much error is there, PE after 1. It's similar to that only, right? In this case, x1, x2 are same as PE after 0 and PE after 1, x1, x2. And P0, P1 corresponds to similar to P1, P2, like that you can think. Is the average probability of error. Okay, let me go to map rule. And we considered P0 equals to 1 by 4, P1 equals to 3 by 4. Then and according to map rule, this is a threshold you are keeping, right? Whichever is maximum that you are considering. If y less than this value, you are decoding that like bit 0. If y is more than this value, then you are trying to decode this like bit 1. Because you want to see whichever is maximum, right? A posteriori probability. If this is bigger than this one, you are decoding like bit 1. If this is bigger than this one, then you are decoding this like bit 0. Now, what is the average probability of error in this case? Average probability of error. Or I'll try to mark this one. Can you just tell me what is this? Yeah, what is this area? Is it P after 0? Or which one is true? I'll try to ask a question. Is this area corresponds to probability of error after transmitting bit 0 or P naught into P after 0? Which one?
Second one.
Second one, right? Because this corresponds to P naught into F Y after 0, right? Okay, that's fine. Then what about this area? Yeah, what about this green color area? The P1 into P after 1, right? Now, if you want to know what is P, probability of error, average probability of error, you need to add this one and this one. You need to add both, right? That means this area plus this area corresponds to average probability of error. The two areas. Okay, that's fine. Instead of this one, if you try to apply ML rule here also, this ML rule, right? ML rule threshold is 0. 0 is the threshold. If you apply 0 as a threshold, your probability of error will be, if this is the threshold, then this will be the error, and along with this, this will be the error. This extra part also coming, right? Along with this earlier part, this additional part also you are getting. This is giving more error compared to map rule, right? It's the optimal rule. Map rule is the optimal by default. Okay, that's fine. It's already 1 hour, right? Okay, you are having a quiz on this Saturday, right? Is it Saturday? You can see I already posted that you have a quiz on this Saturday based on your probability course, entire course. And I posted an assignment also. You can look into that one. Assignment number one. Deadline is this Monday. That coming Monday. Okay, it's fine. Okay, do you have any doubts? You can ask me. Yeah, you can ask me if you have any doubts. See, if you interact more, that will be good for you and good for me also. Okay, it's fine. Thank you.